Hi guys, Steph here. Now, recently I received a message from a viewer who said he's got a fountain pen that doesn't work, it doesn't take in ink or whatever. He sent me a photograph. I looked at the photograph and I can see that he's got a Sheaffer Touchdown fountain pen. So I thought, right, okay, how can I help? Now, coincidentally, I'm just in the process of actually servicing this particular pen. This is a Sheaffer Craftsman number 52. As I say, I'm just in the process of servicing it, so I thought what I'll do a video on servicing it. Hopefully it'll help him, and hopefully it'll help lots of you viewers out there if you've got this particular pen. Now, the Touchdown fountain pens, they came in numerous different guises, different colors, different trim, etc. If this isn't the, you know, your specific model, it doesn't matter. As long as if it's a Touchdown fountain pen, the same principle will apply in what we're actually going to do. So I hope this will help, well, that particular gentleman, and help a lot of other people. So let's get straight into it. So this pen, it's in absolutely beautiful condition as it is, in an excellent condition. As I say, it's the Touchdown fountain pen, but I can actually feel and I can hear that maybe the O-ring inside needs to be replaced. Now, what you'll find is with a lot of these Touchdown fountain pens and the snorkel pens, when you come to remove the O-ring, the originals were actually a white colour. So if it's the original one, then yeah, it needs replacing. Now, I've not tested this pen, but I believe it may actually still work. The sack actually feels quite supple, but when you receive the pens, because of the age of them, and I say the age, we're talking 1950s, 1960s, it's best to give them a service, replace the sack, replace the O-ring. So let's get on with it, as I say. What I tend to do, well, what you need to do is undo or take the barrel off, and what you'll find, it's got this outer sort of sack protector, like so. Again, some of yours will you may have a silver one or a chrome sack protector. It doesn't matter. Again, the principle is the same. What I suggest is that before you begin to remove the protector or the sack or whatever, soak the pen, put the pen in water, so you know the water goes maybe to the top of the section there. Leave it overnight just to soak, and that'll help with sort of cleaning the pen, which we'll show you in a moment. But first and foremost, what we need to do is remove this sack protector. Again, if yours is an old one, what you may need to do is apply some heat just around this area here, because these were actually sort of glued or shellacked on. What they also have is sort of little crimps there, you can see to the top. So, you know, the shellacked on and also crimped on. So what we need to do is get our little rubber pieces. These are just simple bicycle inner tubes. You can see this one, I've actually made some seals with them, but again, it's a very handy piece of, well, not equipment, but it's handy to have. So we'll use that to grip the section, and we're using this particular rubber to remove the sack protector. Now, I can feel this one is actually quite loose. There we go. So that one came off nice and easily. So let's put that to one side. So as I say, if you're finding a little bit difficult to remove yours, apply some heat and that will actually help it, well, help you remove the sack protector. So as you can see, right, as I'm pressing it, I've just felt, there we go. So although that bit there is quite supple, excuse me, as I press the end there, you can see that's now beginning to solidify. So absolutely, we're right in actually removing it and replacing it. So what I'm going to do now is just get my nail. Now, you'll have to excuse me on some of these things that I'm doing because I'm working over the camera and it's a little bit difficult. So we can throw that away, discard it, and there we have it. So that's what you should have now. is a nice clean, well, yeah, they call it the nipple on the section there. Okay, so that's where the new sack is going to go on. Now, just a little bit earlier, I told you about soaking the section in water. And what that'll do, I've already done it, so, you know, I've come a little bit prepared. Again, I'm going to get my piece of rubber. And what we need to do is grip the feed and the nib like so. And I suggest you grip it from the top of the nib and underneath like so. And then what we can actually do very gently on this particular model, we can actually unscrew and take out the nib like so. Once again, this does not apply to all the touchdown fountain pens. There's only certain ones like the Craftsman, which is this one, and I believe the Cadet, etc., which allows you to unscrew the nib unit. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pop these in the ultrasonic cleaner. If you haven't got an ultrasonic cleaner, pop these in a little bit of water. If you've got a barrel brush like this, which what I use, give the section a clean out before we install the new sack. So I'm just going to clean that and then pop back in a moment. Okay, so what we've done now, we've cleaned the section and the nib. We give it 4 minutes in the ultrasonic cleaner, so everything's nice and clean. Don't forget as well, a lot of people just forget little tiny things, like don't forget to clean the thread here as well. So everything's lovely and clean now. So what we'll do, we'll now install a new sack onto the sack nipple, or the section if you like. So what we need to do is bring on our new sack. So let's open the packet like so. There's the new sack, and if we just go inside here, a bit difficult to get it out, and there we have it. That's the O-ring that we need to use. I'll just pop that to one side for now. Incidentally, I'm sure some of you people will say to me, yes, but where do we get our supplies from? Well, nice and simply, you can get your supplies from these people here. But don't worry about that. I'll leave you a link to the bottom once we've done the video. So let's pop them to one side. As you'll see, the sack here is quite a long one. They come in these long lengths, and what we need to do is cut it down to size. These, incidentally, are thin-walled sacks. They're a lot thinner than your sort of standard sacks, if you like. So what I need to do is bring on my cutting board, and then what we'll do, we'll simply install the new sack into the sap protector like so. You can see it protrudes quite a bit. And then if I just get my razor like so, and first and foremost, what I'm going to do is just simply push it down as far as it'll go and just cut it at the end like so. And what you'll see, there's some, just a slight little bit protruding to the top there. So we'll pop that out like so. And now what we need to do is just measure it. Now don't forget, this sap protector sits like so once it's on. So what you need to do, as you can see, just sort of measure it and cut the sack to size. So the sack sits just on this little ridge here. So if you see there, we need to cut it about halfway on this particular area there. So if I pop, well, if I pop the sack to the side of the sap protector, and it's not an exact science, you don't have to measure it, but what I'm going to do, as I say, is cut it halfway down this sort of slightly expanded piece. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to, let's get a good position, because as I say, it's always difficult doing these things over the camera. So there we go, I'm going to cut it approximately there. Okay, so if I now pop that back, and in effect that's sort of roughly how it's going to sit inside. So if you can imagine the sections like that. As I say, it's not an exact science, so don't worry about it if you're a couple of millimeters out. It doesn't really matter. Right, so what we need to do now is pop the sack onto the sack nipple. Now, at this point, we need to bring on our shellac, and we also need to bring on your sack spreaders. These are my sack spreaders here. So we'll pop that in like so. Let's get the shellac, open that up like so, and then apply the shellac onto the sack nipple like so. Just rotate it as you apply it. Let's put that to one side. Get your sack spreaders, pop it on like so. I like to give it a little bit of a turn, and there we have it. And that's how easy it is to install a new sack onto the section. So what I'm going to do now, because obviously we want that to dry, I'm going to put this section and the sack to one side, and as we carry on, and also remove the sack spreaders. In fact, what we'll do, we'll move the sack protector to one side, and even the nib. So what we need to do now, because we need to replace the O-ring inside the barrel. So in fact, we're going to put the cap to one side as well. So what we need to do at this point is bring on a screwdriver that is long, that will reach inside the barrel. The reason for that, the plunger, or the plunger tube, if you like, is connected by a screw in the end here. So what we need to do is put the screwdriver inside. Now, at this point, what I'd like to say is just be very careful, because sometimes it's a little bit difficult to locate the screw at the end. And if you actually start turning it, because the plunger tube is made of aluminium, you will ruin it, you'll break it, you'll put a hole in it, whatever. So you've got to be very careful when you locate the screw. So what I'm going to do, I'm just, as I'm talking to you, I'm feeling round to locate the said screw, and I think I've just found it. So what we do now is turn and turn, and I think that should be enough. And there we have it. There's the retaining screw inside. Now, what we should be able to do now is, if we unscrew the plunger and just gently remove the plunger knob to the end there. So what we can actually do now is just simply pull the plunger as far as it'll go, and it just simply pops out of the barrel like so. Excuse me. Now, what we need to do is try and show you the O-ring inside. So I'm going to bring on my little inspection torch. And I don't know if you... There we go. Hopefully you can just see it in there. The O-ring is just inside the barrel there. So let's pop that to one side. We need to remove the O-ring. And again, a little bit difficult over the camera, so you have to just bear with me. I think I can see it there. Says he. In fact, just bear with me. Believe it or not, I've had to put on some glasses. No, it doesn't make it a great deal better, but I'm hoping you can see that. Try and keep it in in the camera. Very difficult doing this over the camera. Right, I was going to give up then, but no, just for you people, what I'm going to do, I'm going to carry on. Some of them tend to be quite solidified. Right. Right, what I'm going to do, I apologise, I'm going to just switch the camera off and bring it close up to me. I'm using my loop. I'll start it off and then come back to you. Okay, so I've managed to loosen it. So, like I say, it's just difficult doing these procedures over the camera. I normally have a loop. There we go, there it is. We're going to sort of remove it. Right, it's just, it's out of the ridge, out of the sort of recess. In fact, it might be just easier if I just push it out. There it is. It's actually loose, but I'm hoping you might see it sort of pop out of the cam, out of the, there we go. Hey! My word. Right, so there we go. So, as I said earlier, some of them are white. This one's not white, it's black, so that's not a problem. But if I pull it, you can see there's no rubber left in it. It's literally sort of solidified. So we've removed the O-ring, the old O-ring. Normally, believe me, it's a lot easier than that. I'm working at arm's length and it's a little bit more difficult. So just bear with me. Now, what I'd like to do, I just simply clean the area. Again, with my wire brush, you can clean the whole barrel if you wish. Like so. Just turn in the barrel as we're going along. And give it a blow. Now, if we bring on the new O-ring, at this point, what we do, I need to bring on some tissue to my left. I've got some silicone grease. So what you need to do is get a touch of silicone grease on your fingers and cover the new O-ring in silicone grease. Doesn't need a lot, just a little bit. So that's done now. So what I'm going to do is just present the O-ring to the pen, or to the barrel, should I say, like so. Wipe my fingers of any excess grease. And what I tend to use is just simply a normal little, oh dear. Just bear with me. There we go, so we get in there. Basically what I'm trying to do, inside there's a recess where the O-ring will sit inside the recess. As I say, I'm having a bit of difficulty because I'm working over the camera. So I think we've got it in there now, or have we? Right, again, I need to apologize and I need to do it close up. So just bear with me a second. Okay, so we've done it now. As I say, I needed to use my trusted little loop. It's just a little bit fiddly, and to do it at arm's length over a camera obviously proved a little bit more difficult. But if I can get my inspection torch again, and I don't know if it's actually visible, says he. I'm hoping inside there you can see the O-ring is now fitted. The new O-ring is fitted into sort of the recess there. Okay, so I'm hoping that's a little bit clear. So what we've done now, we've replaced and we've put a brand new O-ring into the barrel. What we also need to do at this point, if you look there, you'll see it's got a little air hole to the end of the barrel. Just get a needle or something very fine. See, I'm even having a difficulty locating the hole. There we go. And just give it a little twist with your needle. Clean out any dirt that may be in that particular air hole. So as we're waiting for the sack to dry, we can actually install the plunger tube into the barrel. Again, I'm bringing on my little silicone grease, and I'm just applying a very thin layer of grease to the tube. Now, what we do is we bring on our screwdriver, and I don't know if you can actually see that. I'm sort of literally balancing it on top of the screw. Whoops-a-daisy. Again, if you've got the room, let me just do it like so. You can't see it, but I'm balancing it on top like so. And what I'm going to do is just, there we go, push it all the way to the top through the tube like so. Now, what we can do is push that all the way home through the new O-ring like so. We can now get the plunger knob, present it to the end, and screw it back in place like so. Give it just a hand tight. When you're screwing it back in, make sure it's just hand tight. If you're over tighten it, what you'll find is this knob here will split. So don't over tighten the screw. So we can push it in and out a couple of times just to get the silicone there sort of covered the tube and the new O-ring, etc. That's feeling very nice. And at this point, what you'll do, if you put your tongue on the end here and pull and push it, you'll feel a lot of suction inside the barrel. So there we go, we've put a new O-ring into the barrel. I'm going to pop that down. We're going to wait for the sack over there to dry. I don't know, some people say 20 minutes, half an hour, whatever. I'm going to give it, I don't know, maybe half an hour. I'll pop back and then we'll pop it all back together again. Okay, so it's been over half an hour, so maybe even longer. So now let's bring on all the other bits that we need. So let's pop the barrel to one side. So what we need now, we've put the sack onto the section. We need to bring on a little bit of dusting powder. Let's just dip my finger in there and just give it a light coating of dusting powder like so. Let's pop that to one side and let's just give it a blow. So blow off any excess dust on that, and then bring on the shellac again. Okie dokie, like so, and apply some shellac to where the protector will sit. So there we go, all I've done is put the brush towards it and rotated the section. Now get the protector and just simply push it back, just giving it sort of very gentle rocking motion, and there we have it. So that's now fitted back onto the section. What I also like to do, you can see, as I said earlier, they have these little crimps to the top there. I think there's about four crimps. Off camera I'll do it, but what I like to do, I've got a little punch that I just give it a little tap with a punch and a hammer just to close them crimps to hold it into place. So there we have it. So we installed a new sack into the pen or onto the section. Now what we're going to do now is put the nib back in. So when I put these nibs in, once again I bring on my silicone grease, and what I like to do, a tiny wee bit of, not a lot, but just if you like a bead, says he, there we go, just a bead of silicone grease to the thread on the nib. And let's get this section, let's pop the nib back into place and just simply screw it back on and just give it a little bit of a twirl as you're doing it, like so, just so that the silicone grease sort of spreads around. So let's bring on the rubber again. Once again, not too tight, just simply hand tight. Don't forget, everything's hand tight, don't go over the top or you may ruin the nib or whatever. So let's bring on the barrel. Let's screw the barrel back into place like so. Let's bring on the cap, and there we have it. We've just serviced a Sheaffer Craftsman 52 fountain pen. Incidentally, this Sheaffer, as I say, it's made, well, I've not said it, but if we show you the barrel imprint there, you can see it's made in Australia. One thing I didn't show you, a close-up, as I say, it's the Craftsman 52, and you'll notice it's got a Sheaffer Australia 14 carat, and then underneath it's got the number 52 to relate to the nib, which is a 52. And also another thing on these pens, these are what Sheaffer called the tip dip. Now if you look to the very top of the feed there, you can see this sort of little hole, and that's what they term as the tip dip fountain pen. As I say, they brought these out in lots of different variations. I've actually got another one here. This is actually a Sheaffer Cadet. You can see slightly different, the band is slightly different inside, size wise. Incidentally, size wise, from the top of the cap to the bottom of the barrel, 131 millimeters capped, around the barrel 11 millimeters in diameter. So we've got a Craftsman 52 in grey and a Cadet 23 in black. And once again, whoops, a daisy, says he as he drops it on the floor. If we bring on the nib again for you, this one has Sheaffer and, well, basically everything the same, apart from to the bottom you'll see it's got a number 23. So let's pop the cap back on. So in all intents and purposes, we've got two pens very, very similar, just slight, well, again, the only difference being is the cap bands and the nibs. So let's pop that one to one side. Well, it's as good as time as any to test the pen. So let's bring on the ink. To fill these pens, very similar to sort of, well, no, I'm not going to say similar. How we fill them, nice and simply, the tip dip, they suggest that you just dip the feed just so that the tip dip section or the hole there is covered. You pull out the plunger, and how we fill it is by just simply pressing down in one swift movement. It doesn't fill by pulling, it fills only with a downward stroke. So let's do that. So let's dip it in the ink, and okay, so that'll do us just for a writing sample. Let's give it a little bit of a wipe. Pop the ink to one side, screw back the plunger knob, and once again, when you actually fill these pens, if you look at the instructions that come with this particular pen, Sheaffer suggests that you push down on the plunger once and actually count down 10 seconds, but just for a writing sample we just did it a couple of seconds. So let's see how the pen actually writes. So what we have is a Sheaffer, and this one being the Craftsman, and it's the number 52. Writing nicely and writing with a fine line. It's quite a hard nib, there's no variation in the line. It's writing with a fine line, but as you can see, we've now serviced the pen, it's in full working order, writing with a lovely fine line. So that's how easy it is to service a Sheaffer Touchdown fountain pen. This one will be looking for a new home, so if you're interested, maybe get in touch with me. I hope this video was helpful to, well, for that particular viewer. I'm sure it'll be helpful to other people as well who are looking to service their Sheaffer Touchdown pen. Don't forget, if you don't feel confident in what you're actually doing, send it to somebody who knows what they're doing. Otherwise, you may break or ruin your pen. So unless you feel confident, unless you feel competent enough, don't try servicing your own pen. It's not worth it. Just simply send it to somebody and they'll do it for you. So I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope you've enjoyed looking at the pen. As always, as much as I love showing them to you, leave a comment below. But for now, I'll just say bye bye now.